Good morning, my dear students. Today we shall read the most important chapter among the geographic part. My dear students, we all of know which are the important deadly needs of human beings. Come on, let us say, come on, anyone in the class? Yes, very good. Air, very good, very good. Next, water, very good. Then, food, very good. And many other, some important basic needs for human beings. Among these, we study today about India water resources. Yes. In this chapter, we are going to learn about some important aspects regarding this chapter. That are the first important factor in this chapter is importance of water resources. The second is major rivers of India. Then third important factor shall we learn in this chapter is irrigation and their meaning and its need. Then types of irrigation and their distribution. Then multi-purpose river valley projects. Regarding these, all these aspects, we are going to learn this water resource chapter. Yes. My dear student, all of us know how much water is important for every human being. Not only human, animals also needs water. Yes. Water is the most important, precious natural resource. Even without water, it is impossible to maintain life, to sustain life. Human beings need very much. Okay, my dear students, let me say, why and where and what purpose we need to water. Yes, the first one is, come on, cooking, good. Then where we use the water? Washing, very good. Then drinking, yes. Then agriculture, very good. Yes, generation of hydroelectricity. Yes, good. Industries, right. Fishing, good. Navigation, very good. And many other time we are using water. Yes, once again, the water is the most important natural resource. For it is used for drinking, cooking, washing, agriculture, hydroelectricity, industries, navigation, fishing, and many other needs. We are using water. This water can be divided into surface water and ground water. Surface water and ground water. The surface water resources are right. Very good. Rainfall. That is the rainfall is the surface water resource. Then rivers. Good. Tanks. Springs. Yes. Lakes. Yes. These are the surface resource of surface of what? Surface water. Groundwater surface. The another type of water resource, that is groundwater surface. Yes. The surface of water, firstly, surface of water resource are rainfall, rivers, lakes, tanks, springs. India has an extensive surface of water resources. Then, let us know the major rivers of India. India has many river systems. They are the natural resource of the country. Yes, forest is also a natural resource of the country. Minerals is also a natural resource of our country. Yes, although water is also most important natural resource of our country. The rivers are useful for irrigation, generation of hydroelectricity, and inland waterways, fishing, and many etc. We are using water resource. The river system of India can be divided into how many groups? Two groups. The river system of India can be divided into two groups. That are the rivers of North India. The rivers of North India and the rivers of Peninsular India. Yes. The water resource, the rivers can be divided into two types. The North rivers of India, the Peninsular rivers of India. Yes. Firstly, let us know which are the northern rivers of India, and they are also known as Himalayan rivers. Northern rivers are called as Himalayan rivers also. The important northern rivers of India, anybody in the class? Anybody in the class? Yes, very good. Indus River, very good. Then Ganga, very good. And Brahmaputra and many other tributaries. Also, the north rivers of India. Yes. Firstly, the river Indus are called as Sindhus. Sindhu river rises near Mount Kailash. Kailash is a Tibet. Tibet is called as Kailash. River Indus or Sindhu rises near the Mount Tibet or Mount Kailash. Then initially it flows north westwards. North to westwards. Then it flows towards the southwest. And it enters to Pakistan. Finally, it joins Arabian Sea near Karachi, which is located in Pakistan. Finally, it joins the Arabian Sea near Karachi. Then, the total length of the river Indus is 2,897 kilometers, of which 709 kilometers lies in India. Among 2,897 kilometers rivers Indus, 70 among this 709 kilometers lies in Indian area, Indian land. But the major part of its course is in Pakistan. Yes. It receives many tributaries such as Jhelum, Chenab, Bias, Ravi and Satluj are the tributaries of Sindhu River. Yes. Then another most important river of India is Ganga. The Ganga River is the largest river of India. Largest river of India. Its total length is 2,525 kilometer. 2,525 kilometer it has. Then it rises in the Gangotri Glacier. Where does it rises? The origin of the Ganga is Gangotri Glacier. Then it flows towards the south. Flows towards the south and southeast. Then it enters Bangladesh, where it joins the Brahmaputra River. The Ganga flows towards the southeast. Then it enters the Bangladesh, where it joins Brahmaputra. After it joins the Brahmaputra, it continues as Padma. It has called Padma and finally flows into the Bay of Bengal. Bay of Bengal. Its major tributaries of Ganga River are called Yamuna, Ghagra, Gandak, Ramaganga, Gomati, Sarada, San, Kosi. Of these are tributaries of Ganga. And the important and the longest tributary of Ganga is Yamuna. Yamuna is the longest tributary of Ganga River. Then another north river of India is, that is Brahmaputra. As Brahmaputra river rises, where does it rises? This rises Lake Manasa Sarovara, which was located in Tibet. Which was located in Tibet. Yes, Brahmaputra rises near Manasa Sarovara, which was located in Tibet. Then it flows towards the east. It flows towards the east. It enters in India through a narrow gorge in Arunachal Pradesh. Then it flows to the west and turns to the south in Bangladesh, where it joins the Ganga. Its length, the length of the Brahmaputra River is 2580 kilometers. Then rivers of South India, the three important north rivers we read, that are Sindhus, firstly, Sindhus, second, Ganga, then Brahmaputra. these three are the major rivers of northern India and their tributaries. Then the rivers of South India shall be read now. Many rivers flow across South India. They are also known as peninsular rivers. Peninsular rivers. Most of the rises, most of peninsular rivers rises in the Western Ghats. Western Ghats. The important river of South India are Mahanadi. Yes. Then Godavari. Then Krishna, Kaveri, Narmada. Yes. Tapi. Then and their tributaries are the major rivers of South India. These can be occupied into east flowing. East flowing. These can be grouped into east flowing and west flowing rivers. Then the east flowing, there are divided as east flowing rivers and south flowing, west flowing rivers. These rivers, the peninsular rivers can be divided into east flowing rivers and west flowing rivers. Which are called the east flowing rivers? Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri are the east flowing rivers. This Mahanadi, where it is Mahanadi rises? Mahanadi rises Shiva range. It has flows towards the east side. It has in the length 851 km. And joins the Bay of Bengal. It joins the Bay of Bengal. Then Mahanadi rises in the Shiva range. Mahanadi rises in the Shiva range. Then the another most important southern or peninsular east flowing river is Godavari. Godavari is the largest river in South India. South India's largest river is Godavari. It rises in Trayambaka. Then it flows towards the east. Flows towards the east. It has 1465 km. It flows 1465 km and joins the, finally it joins the Bay of Bengal. Then Godavari River rises in Trayambaka. Already we read. Then River Krishna, which is also important major river of southern India or peninsular rivers. It is near Mahabaleshwara. It is near Mahabaleshwara. Then it flows towards the southeast. South, it flows southeast, towards southeast. Then it has 1400 kilometers. And it has joined, it is also joined Bay of Bengal. Then this Krishna, river Krishna rises near Mahabaleshwara. Yes, Mahabaleshwara. Krishna rivers has some different various tributaries are there. Which are they? The tributaries of Krishna are Bhima, Tungabhadra, Koyna, Ghataprabha and Malaprabha are called tributaries of Krishna river. Then the another most important peninsular river is called Kaveri. Kaveri rises at Talakaveri. Kaveri rises at Talakaveri. which was located in Kodagu district. It flows towards the east and joins Bay of Bengal. Okay, let us where Kaveri rises. Kaveri rises at Talakaveri. Yes. Then another most important some tributaries are called the Yamavati, Simsa, Krishna's tributaries. Kaveri tributaries of Kaveri are called Simsa, Yamavati, Kabini, Arkavati, Lakshmana Tirtha, Suvarnavati, and Bhavani. Bhavani are the main tributaries of Kaveri. Then river Narmada rises in Amarakantaka Hills. Amarakantaka Hills. And flows westward. It has 1312 kilometers. Through a narrow gorge called Marble Gorge. And it joins finally Arabian Sea. This Narmada, another most important peninsular river, Narmada, this can be rises in Amarakantaka Hills. As well, it as rises in Amarakantaka Hills. The Tapi rises near Multai. This Tapi river rises in Multai. It flows westward. It has 24 kilometers. And finally it joins Arabian Sea. Yes, where does Tapi rises? Tapi rises in Multai. Very good. Then many other west flowing rivers are short. Many other rivers, west flowing rivers are there. But they are very short and swift. Important among them are Sabaramati, Vedati River, Sharavati, Kali, Netravati, and Periyar are the west flowing rivers. Then also Mandovi, Zuhari, also this Vedati, Sharavati, Kali, these are west flowing rivers and also swift rivers. Okay, let us learn about the another important factor regarding this chapter is irrigation. Irrigation. What is irrigation? What is the meaning of irrigation? Yes, let us see. The artificial supply of water for the purpose of agriculture is called irrigation. Once again, the artificial supply of water for the purpose of agriculture is called irrigation. It refers to the supply of water to agriculture. Land from rivers, reservoirs, tanks, or from underground resources. Okay, it is what are the need of irrigation? Yes, the most important need for irrigation, important need of irrigation for our agriculture, because India is a full of agricultural country. Therefore, it needs a regular and sufficient supply of water. Agricultural in India depends on mainly monsoon rainfall. Agriculture of India depends only monsoon rainfall. It is a regional, but also it is uncertain and unevenly distributed. So that is why irrigation is important for India's agriculture. There are certain crops which require a larger and regular water supply, such as rice, sugarcane, and many crops needs very much water. Besides, it increases the yield and production of crops required regularly supply of water. This can be provided only by the irrigation, which is very essential in India. Okay, let us read types of irrigation. How many types of irrigations we can see? The important types of irrigations in India are wells, canals, tanks. Recently, other type of irrigations such as sprinkler method and drip irrigation method also have been seen, have been introduced in our India recently. Okay, let us think about well irrigation. What is well irrigation? What are the uses of well irrigation? It is the most important type of irrigation in India. Nearly 60.7% of the total irrigated area from the well irrigation. Well irrigation is possible even in areas of low rainfall. It is cheap and easy to dig wells, and they do not require a superior technology. It is easy even for small farmers to dig wells. Then well irrigation is largely practiced in the Ganga plains. Ganga plains including Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and West Bengal. These states are having more well irrigation method. In the South India, well irrigation is also there, to widely practiced in the Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka and Odisha. Then wells are two types. Again, wells are classified into two types. One is open wells, and the second type of well is tube wells. Tube well irrigation has become widespread in India. Next, the second type of irrigation method we can see, that is canal irrigation method, which has occupies the second place after the well irrigation, and accounts for about 27% of the total irrigated area. India has one of the world's largest canal system. The government is responsible for the construction and maintenance of the canals. See, there are two types of canals are there. Inundation canals and perennial canals. And the second one is perennial canals. Inundation canals and perennial canals. In the inundation canals, water is drawn directly from the river without building dam. It's directly using from the rivers without building any dams. In perennial canals, dams are constructed across the rivers and water is stored in the reservoirs and used for agriculture through the canals. Then canal irrigation is extensive in Uttar Pradesh. Not only in Uttar Pradesh, even we can see in Punjab, Haryana, Bihar, Rajasthan, Andhra Pradesh, Gujarat, Tamil Nadu, Odisha, Bengal and Karnataka states were also used canal irrigation systems. It's mainly the another most important irrigation method is the tank irrigation method. A tank is a natural and man-made hollow on the earth's surface into which rain water is collected. This water is used for irrigation. This is called tank irrigation. Most of the tanks are non-perennial. In recent years, the area under tank irrigation has been decreased. Tank irrigation has been decreased in these days. Now only 3% of the total irrigated area is under the tank irrigation system in India. It is mainly found in Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Odisha, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh. Then once again, we recall the previous points. Where did Ganga River born? Or where did Ganga River rises? Yes, Ganga River rises in Gangotri. Very good. Okay, where does Indo River rises? Indo River rises in? Very good. Yes, Mount Kailash of Tibet. Where does Kaveri River rises? Tala Kaveri. Then Krishna River rises in Mahabaleshwara. Then Godavari River rises in Trayambaka. Okay. Let us list out the North Indian rivers and South Indian rivers. Come on, anybody in the class? List out the North Indian rivers and South Indian rivers. The North Indian rivers are called, yes, Ganga, Brahmaputra, Indus. Very good. The South Indian rivers are called Krishna, Kaveri, Narmada, Godavari and Tapi. Then, what are the meanings of irrigation? While you coming tomorrow, you can write the meaning of irrigation. Okay, before that, we will discuss once again. The artificial supply of water for the purpose of agriculture is called irrigation. Okay. Thank you, my dear students. I hope you are all understand all these aspects regarding this chapter. I am very happy to hear to teach this. Okay, my dear students. Once again.